Everyone's on a diet.
Everybody's on a diet. Everybody's on a diet. They're consuming more content than ever, so they're getting fat on content and skinny on ads.
I'm here at the LinkedIn studios in the Empire State Building with the fabulous Linda Boff, who is not just the CMO of GE, but we're going to hear in a moment all the roles she has at GE.
It's wonderful to be here with you, Nadine. I love talking to you, and I just love your view on the marketing industry, so it's great to be here talking.
Your title is CMO, but you have like eight other things that you do, right?
So I seem to have collected some jobs along the way. So I'm officially our Chief Marketing and Communications Officer, so communications rolls up to me. And in the last year or so, I've also taken on learning and development, which is a very big deal at GE. Our leadership training is huge. And very recently, I became president of our foundation. So those things sound a little eclectic. They actually do knit together really beautifully because they all bring together our reputation, our brand, both internally and externally, how we show up to our different stakeholders. So makes all the sense in the world to me. Makes for some busy times, but I wouldn't have it any other way. It's great.
So what innovations coming down the pipe right now that you're enthralled with?
Our company was founded by a man who's a household name, Thomas Edison, and we never really forget that, right? We never forget that when it comes to, as Thomas Edison said, taking the world's toughest problems and trying to solve them. And I think we have always tried to imbue that in marketing. And for us, that has often been, you and I have talked about this, sort of zigging when others zag, not necessarily following the crowd. And by the way, look, sometimes that's meant that we've been out there earlier than perhaps made sense, right? You know, we were out there when platforms were fairly nascent. And at the same time, we've been out there in the early, early days of Instagram and so many other things, LinkedIn. We've been on the LinkedIn platform for so long and had, you know, our blogs, et cetera. As we think about opportunities in marketing, you know, it is the golden age of storytelling. You know, Peter Dinklage was right at the end of Game of Thrones, whether we all like the end or not, it is all about a story. And yet figuring out, Nadine, not just what the story is, because in some ways that's not the hardest part. I think the craft of that and the magic, right, of the creativity is, it's hard, but it's doable. Where to put what we create so that it actually has attention and engagement and drives, you know, customer loyalty, customer interest. Listen, that is harder and harder, and it's ironic, isn't it? We have more channels than we've ever had, and yet the appetite for commercial interruption, if we want to call it that, I think is not high.
No.
So
everyone's on a diet.
Everybody's on a diet. Everybody's on a diet. They're consuming more content than ever, so they're getting fat on content and skinny on ads.
Yes.
So we have to, like, figure out what that looks like. But I mean, look, I think that the challenge is also the opportunity. And it's not sort of shying away from we can't. It's sort of figuring out what could this look like. And that's where we try to spend our time in the possible.
We were talking about your infrastructure. You have, what is it, 2,000 plus marketers?
We have a couple thousand. Yeah, we have a couple thousand around the world. Now, they're in all different kinds of roles. Some are product marketers, some are strategic sellers, some are brand folks. So, you know, I think at a company like ours, and maybe this is true for others, marketing just comes in a lot of different flavors. Our focus now in marketing and frankly across GE is growth. Right? How do we grow? How do we make sure that our business objectives are our marketing objectives? I'd like to think that's always been the case. But I think in the last year, we've had a new CEO, fantastic Larry Culp, and he's really driven this sense of focus and prioritization.
What is the your most favorite career tip that you've either received or given? And there can be a couple, whatever comes to mind.
So the one that I always go to, and I've said this to many people, although it was something that was given to me, and it's, again, something that's very simple, which is this idea you're never as good as you are on your best day, never as bad as you are on your worst. I think to feel overly confident is something that I think can lull you into a sense of non-reality. And to beat yourself up too good is also to not give credence. So I try to keep that balance. I try to keep it for my team. You know, when you're dealing with as many issues as you may deal with as a big and fairly complicated company, it's always good to have a little bit of perspective and context. So so that's a chestnut that I sort of always go back to.
Okay, those are great. That gave me goosebumps because, you know, I can relate to that entirely. Thank you so much, Linda, for joining us today.
My pleasure. Loved being here.
Likewise. And thank you for being with us on Top of Mind.